Welcome to a lesson in which we'll discover the rules for multiplying integers by analyzing the patterns when multiplying integers. So to begin, we know that a positive times a positive is equal to a positive. So we'll start with a product of positives and work our way toward a product of a positive and a negative. So we'll start with 5 times 4, keep the first factor 5, and then decrease the second factor by 1 each time. So notice how the second factor starts at 4, and then decreases by 1 to 3, and then 2, 1, 0, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, and then negative 4. So we know 5 times 4 equals 20, 5 times 3 equals 15, 5 times 2 equals 10, 5 times 1 equals 5, and 5 times 0 equals 0. So as we continue to decrease the second factor by 1, the pattern that we see in the products should continue. So looking at the products, notice how as the second factor decreases by 1, the product decreases by 5 each time. Notice that 20 minus 5 equals 15, 15 minus 5 equals 10, 10 minus 5 equals 5, and 5 minus 5 equals 0. So if we continue subtracting 5, we should be able to find the remaining products. And since 0 minus 5 equals negative 5, 5 times negative 1 equals negative 5. And negative 5 minus 5 equals negative 10. And therefore, 5 times negative 2 equals negative 10. And negative 10 minus 5 equals negative 15. So 5 times negative 3 equals negative 15. And finally, negative 15 minus 5 equals negative 20. And therefore, 5 times negative 4 equals negative 20. So if we focus on these last four rows here, or these last four products, we should recognize that we've discovered that a positive times a negative is negative. So let's go ahead and formalize this on the next slide. Here's the new rule that we just discovered: a positive times a negative is negative. But because of the commutative property, multiplication, that says A times B equals B times A, for example, we know that 3 times 2 equals 6, and so does 2 times 3. So because we can change the order of multiplication and not affect the product, if a positive times a negative is equal to a negative, then a negative times a positive must also be negative. Which means now we have 3 rules for multiplying integers. Again, we know that a positive times a positive is positive. And then here, if the signs are different, notice how the product is negative. So now the only rule remaining is when we have a negative times a negative. So we'll try to discover that rule by starting with what we know now: a negative times a positive is negative. And then in this case, we're going to keep the first factor negative 5, and then again decrease the second factor by 1, where the second factor will start at 4 and decrease by 1 until it reaches negative 4. Notice how the second factors are 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, and negative 4. So again, we should already know these first 5 products. We now know that a negative times a positive is negative. So negative 5 times 4 equals negative 20. Negative 5 times 3 equals negative 15. Negative 5 times 2 equals negative 10. Negative 5 times 1 equals negative 5. And negative 5 times 0 equals 0. So again, by analyzing the pattern in these products, we should be able to find the remaining products where we have a negative times a negative. So notice how the products are negative 20, negative 15, negative 10, negative 5, and 0. In the last table, these were decreasing by 5, but in this table, they're increasing by 5. Negative 20 plus 5 equals negative 15. Negative 15 plus 5 equals negative 10. Negative 10 plus 5 equals negative 5. And negative 5 plus 5 equals 0. So again, this pattern will continue, and therefore for the next product, or negative 5 times negative 1, it must be equal to 0 plus 5, which would be positive 5. So negative 5 times negative 1 equals positive 5. For the next product, we would have 5 plus 5, which is positive 10, and therefore negative 5 times negative 2 equals positive 10. And then for the next product, 10 plus 5 equals 15. So negative 5 times negative 3 equals positive 15. And finally, 15 plus 5 equals 20. And therefore, negative 5 times negative 4 equals positive 20. So again, focusing on these last four products here, we should be able to recognize that a negative times a negative is positive. So again, let's go ahead and formalize our four rules for multiplying integers. Notice in these first two rules, if the signs are different, the product is negative. And in these two rules, if the signs are the same, the product is positive. Let's go ahead and show these again by looking at our tables. So we started the lesson knowing that a positive times a positive is positive. And then we discovered that a positive times a negative is negative, and also that a negative times a positive is negative. And then we ended by discovering that a negative times a negative is positive. So again, we can say that the product of two integers with different signs is negative, as we see here and here, and the product of integers with the same sign is positive, as we see here and here. Now there is one more thing I'd like to mention before we go. When multiplying several integers at a time, we can determine the sign two factors at a time, or we can use the rules provided here. The product of an odd number of negative integers is negative. So looking at this first example here, notice how we have a product of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 negatives, and since 5 is odd, this product will be negative. Once we know the sign of the product, we can go ahead and ignore the signs and just find the product of their absolute values. So 2 times 3 is 6, times 1 is 6, times 4 is 24, times 2 is 48, so this product is negative 48. This method is a little bit faster than determining the sign for each individual product. And then the product of an even number of negatives is always positive. So here we have a product of 1, 2, 3, 4 negatives, and therefore we know the product will be positive, and therefore this product would be positive 48. Okay, I hope you found this lesson helpful.